Hey dudes, with Blackmagic Design's recent price reductions, both the editor's keyboard and the speed editor are now even more attractive to own. But with the two products sharing so much of the same DNA, I wanted to investigate their real differences. So over the last 3 months, I've been switching between the editor's keyboard and the speed editor on my commercial productions, and this is what I found. So let's get into it. Prior to the last 3 months, this keyboard has been my daily driver, and I'm not a fan. I don't enjoy typing or video editing with it, and it is the reason why I've been looking for an alternative. So if you're like me and you're spending a lot of time behind your computer editing or grading in Resolve and looking for a better keyboard experience, then hopefully this video can shed some light on whether the speed editor or the editor's keyboard are for you. The first question that I needed to answer was, could I supplement a full keyboard with the speed editor? Or if the editor's keyboard for the extra money was a better option for the way that I edit? After 3 months of switching between them, I can say they both outperform a generic keyboard. And they should, because they are native specialty input devices for Resolve's ecosystem. They both are easy to learn and they do make editing in Resolve much, much faster and enjoyable. The thing that I like the most about them is the replaceable mechanical key switches and caps. Both are easy to remove and clean and therefore customize in the future. On closer inspection, the plastic dish keycaps have a gentle ergonomic curvature providing a nice tactile feel. And these red eSports rated key switches respond via soft touch and are certified for a million operations. Combined, the key switches and caps provide a pleasant amount of key travel, providing a very ergonomic typing experience. But in terms of overall ergonomics, the editor's keyboard with the additional palm rest is more comfortable for longer editing sessions. So in brief, both offer an exceptional user experience and both are well worth their respective price points. But without a QWERTY keyboard, for me, the speed editor is just left lacking. You can't complete a full edit without an additional keyboard, which is the fundamental difference between the two. The editor's keyboard has a full traditional set of QWERTY keys, a set of function buttons, a numeric keypad, a set of arrow keys, plus the custom keys from the speed editor. And with each key performing a separate function in Resolve, there's just no comparison. Outside of Resolve, the editor's keyboard can be used as a regular input device, which the speed editor simply can't do. It's just a one-trick pony. So how is the general typing experience with the editor's keyboard? Well, I love mechanical keyboards, but in all fairness, some may not. Even with my ultra-silent M1 Mac, this does not bother me. So if you're not a fan of this, or you require an ultra-quiet typing experience, then the editor's keyboard may not be for you. When you remove all of this from the editor's keyboard, you're left with the speed editor. But that introduces some major hardware-software differences that can't be ignored. First, the editor's keyboard can be used in any of the pages in Resolve, offering you full control over the program in a single device minus a mouse. It can be used to create graphics and titles, search for media, input metadata, navigate folders with the arrow keys, enter FTC mode for switching between timecode and frames, and instantly sort your bins and source tapes. Plus all of the single keystroke edit commands, I think you get the picture. Whereas the speed editor doesn't give you full control in the cut page. You need two devices instead of one. Granted, the speed editor does have some designated shortcut buttons that the editor's keyboard doesn't have, but these functions can still be available on the editor's keyboard by programming your own custom key commands. You can do this by going into the Resolve menu here and setting your keyboard up as you like. If you're coming from another platform, you can choose from a list of mapped keyboard presets like Final Cut Pro, Avid, or even Premiere, which will remap the editor's keyboard shortcut commands to match your muscle memory. In comparison, when using the speed editor in the cut page, you will need to learn and memorize new key combinations and button press duration combinations to perform certain operations. These extra commands are available via the multifunction keys, and these multifunction keys are easily identifiable. You can see here the secondary command words written on the front of the keycaps. What this meant for me, a 13-year Resolve veteran, was the speed editor was frustrating to learn. I was constantly having to look at the keys, which made it feel like I was editing much slower than what I would with the editor's keyboard. The editor's keyboard, on the other hand, felt like second nature, and transitioning to using it was seamless. In terms of build quality, both are made from solid machine metal, and both feel like premium products. The speed editor is a little bit more plastic on the bottom, but it's no big deal. Other differences include the transport control, the battery, and connectivity. But the most obvious is the physical size difference, which is considerable. This keyboard is ginormous. Even with the addition of a separate full-size keyboard, the speed editor is still much smaller in physical size and weight. My big takeaway after 3 months is, when I added a separate keyboard, I couldn't find a layout that made the ergonomics better. It was either good for the keyboard or good for the speed editor, and never both. So when using the speed editor, I found myself constantly rearranging my workspace to match the Resolve page that I was in. As compared with the editor's keyboard, everything just feels like it's in the right place. If you're doing location work, I would still recommend the speed editor, not only because of its portability, but also because of its connectivity choices. The speed editor can connect via Bluetooth or USB-C, so it's a little bit more flexible to use. And the inbuilt battery life is exceptional. I have only had to charge this once in 3 months, and it's not from the lack of use. But Bluetooth connectivity is not the only difference between the two. While the editor's keyboard may not have Bluetooth connectivity, it does have USB-C pass-through connectivity in power, providing one USB-C and two USB-A ports for a mouse or another device, like your Resolve key. And if you're in a pinch, you could always add an external USB drive to import 3D LUTs or copy and transfer files. Now, I have tested this. It's not the fastest for copying data, but if you're out of ports, at least you have an option. The final difference between the two is the transport control. The speed editor doesn't use an onboard resistance motor for the transport control, whereas in shuttle mode, the editor's keyboard transport control uses an integrated electronic clutch powered by the internal battery, with software controlling the tactile feedback. So the more that you turn the wheel, the more it feels like a traditional tape deck with hard stops, opposed to the speed editor, which is just free spinning. The editor's keyboard and the speed editor also have an audible difference during the shuttle command, and you can really, really hear a difference. Even though the shuttle mode clutch in the editor's keyboard is powered by an internal battery, it still requires constant USB-C connection to your computer for charging and general operation. You cannot use this keyboard without a hardwire connection. But this is where the connectivity, the way the battery is utilized, and the transport control differences end. When the shuttle command is disengaged on the editor's keyboard, the battery stops powering the weighted wheel, making the operation of both units feel exactly the same. This is because they use the same roller bearings to produce a smooth, virtually silent, free-spinning movement. Under operation, both revert to how quickly you spin the dial to move faster or slower in the timeline. So what could be improved? Well, between the two units, there's not much that can be improved. The speed editor is designed as a low-cost option where you bring your own keyboard and edit mainly in the cut page. I mean, that's what the product is. It's an all-round solid option. The editor's keyboard, however, it could be improved in two ways. Well, I think anyway, two ways. The first way is by adding Bluetooth connectivity, and I think that would be universally accepted. The second, as much as I love the tactility of the clutch search dial, I actually prefer the one in the speed editor over the editor's keyboard. For me, it equals less parts to break or wear out. Now, that's not to say that these devices are built cheaply, as they're not. They're tanks. I just don't see the need for an analog throwback feature as necessary when editing in a digital medium. Other than these two things, the editor's keyboard wins in every other category except price. So which one should you buy? I think this really has more to do with your desktop setup, the way that you edit, the type of work you do, what your budget is, and what your expected return on your investment is going to be. If you can spare the additional $200 odd, I would recommend the editor's keyboard every day of the week. Mainly because as you grow and learn Resolve, you'll get more and more out of the editor's keyboard as an investment. It just has a lot more functions to learn and use. And with the addition of a mouse, it's pretty much all you need for the entire program. But with all that it has going for it, it's not intended as a portable device. So if portability and Bluetooth connectivity are important for you, then the Speed Editor is a better choice coupled with your own keyboard. If you have any questions, it would be great to hear from you in the comments below. And with that, guys, I will see you in the next one. Bye for now.